So we just finished watching The Trial of Gabriel Fernandez on Netflix, and it's really up. What do you think?
It's the system. The true evil is the system. I mean, not only child abuse, there are so many other things that go wrong.
Domestic violence.
There's so many other things that goes wrong in the world, you know, that you cannot see actually.
Yes.
Yeah, of course.
It's very sad for Gabriel because of the all the injuries he suffered. Watching through all the 6 episodes was quite hard. There were like disturbing images, disturbing facts, like the system has failed Gabriel, and then obviously his mother and her boyfriend, which I think they are the devil themselves. That was one of the hardest documentaries I've had to watch in my entire life.
I cannot imagine that you would do such a thing to a helpless boy.
Yeah.
I mean, kids are being kids, lah. They will be.
Kids will always be naughty.
Yeah, they will be naughty.
They may be naughty, but I don't think violence will solve anything. His other siblings didn't suffer anything, didn't get abused or anything.
Sometimes it just they just do on one kid, lah. It happens, really.
Yeah. But yeah, lah, it's normal, lah. For when I was a kid, also I got beaten up when I misbehave, but that's normal, but not to the extent of, you know, bloods and bruises which led to his death.
Yeah, man, that's torture. He was with his mom for 8 months, right? So I believe throughout the eight months,
in only 8 months that his mother took over his custody, he died. I'm still trying to brain what kind of a mother she is. Anyway, she got life sentence without parole, so
yeah,
it's good. And the boyfriend got the death sentence. But I think child abuse is happening everywhere.
Yeah,
like
it
even
is.
Locally in Singapore, yeah. There's the famous case in Singapore, Nonoy. I think there's just a lot of cases. It just happens that we're watching Netflix and it's Gabriel Fernandez's case. I'm sure there are millions of kids that are suffering from domestic violence and child abuse.
Yeah, of course.
And as much as we all have social workers, I think it's quite hard to really pick out every single case.
Mm.
But in this Gabriel's case, the social workers were, like, in my opinion, they were useless.
Yeah!
They knew that he was in danger, they knew he was at high risk, but they didn't do anything about it just because
they don't want to get involved.
They don't want to get involved, they just want to do the easy work, they don't want to write reports and such. Yeah, even the police that came.
Yeah.
The police that came that saw.
Sheriff, yeah.
Yeah.
They didn't write a report.
They didn't write
like
a report.
Come on, man. That's supposed to be your job.
Yeah.
I don't understand why they can get away with it.
Yeah, but even when Gabriel's teacher tried to report, even the school...
The school said,
you know, you should stay out of this.
Yeah.
Our problem is only to report, not to investigate, blah, 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 blah,
yeah,
blah.
That
blah.
Is the problem. So the system, lah, is the problem.
Yeah. Everybody knew, but no one wanted to go through the trouble of reporting, investigating. Humans are not being humans nowadays. Good documentary, but
very sad one, lah.
And it still is happening.
Yeah.
I mean, if you don't want to be parents, then get someone else to take care of your child, you know. There's so many people that wants to have children but they can't, and here we are, people having children and not taking of their children, abusing their children, throwing their children down the dumpster, like a recent case. Where was it? Is it Topayoh? I'm not sure. If you don't want your child and if you feel that your child is a burden to you, send them to MCYS or something, child services. These people can help get foster parents for these kids. Maybe we should foster a kid.
I got a pamphlet, card. Foster a kid.
I want one more kid.
Too old for that.
She says she's too old for that, so that's why I said maybe we should adopt a kid. Maybe an orphan or a kid that have parents like Gabriel.
I think there are a lot, lah.
But I don't think it's that easy. I think you have to be rich. You have to be rich to foster a kid.
No, lah.
No? I don't want to foster. I want to adopt. Like, I don't want to take care of the child for a few years, and then when the child big already, then the parents want to take them back. I would rather, you know, adopt an orphan or a kid with abusive parents. I want a boy, I want a baby boy. Anyone got lubang for baby boy? we want to adopt. But cannot take back. I will take care of the kid. It'll be good for Lena as well. She's like very lonely. I mean, if you adopt, it doesn't have to be a baby, right? It can be someone. It can be a kid, like maybe 3-4 years old or so. So the gap is not a lot from Lena. Or probably even 5 years old. Lena is 6. If you adopt a kid that's 1 or 2 years younger than her, she won't feel the age gap, you know. I think we should. But first, we need to earn a lot of money first.
I think there are some criteria But I think shouldn't be a problem.
Of course I think they will also look into
look at your family history, household and stuff like that.
Yes, family history. What else?
I think adopting is fine, man. Yeah.
But you want to adopt or not? I want to adopt.
Yeah, if I can, I want.
But I want a boy. Can be a girl also lah.
Oh, girl.
You girl again. We don't have boy. Our boy is so big already. Become man already. Our boy is a man already.
We got another boy, what?
Yeah, we got another boy lah. But yeah, not with us, what? I think Wafi. So Wafi is my firstborn from my previous marriage. He's 8 this year. Like if he were to stay together with us, would be good for Lena as well, right?
Yeah.
Because the age gap is probably not like that 3 far. Years, yeah.
Correct.
3 years. If you guys have any recommendation, the house and what's and where to adopt a kid, let us know. I really want to adopt a kid. I feel like this house needs noisy mornings, more screaming from mommy here. It's stressful, but it's a joyful kind of noise. Yeah. In Malay, we say Maria. Maria means like, you know.
Happening.
Yeah, happening. Anyway, I just got this t-shirt. Malayran, because I'm Malay.
Is this going to be in your vlog?
Yeah, this is going to be my vlog.
About this?
Yeah, it's going to be a casual vlog. Okay, well, this is just a casual vlog. I don't want to stress about my vlog. I just want to hit my goals. That's all. The more I think about videos, the more I think that, you know, maybe I need to work on my edit. I need to buy this. I need to get that.
We should do a video.
About what?
About us, huh?
No, this is my YouTube channel, not yours.
Performing. We should sing a song together.
Yeah. Maybe one of my vlogs can be performing. Maybe I do bass cover or what lah. Then you can sing.
Yeah.
Can be different lah, but I have to be in it lah because it's my YouTube channel. But
yeah, of course you need to be me in it.
This episode is going to be the 12th episode already. So I'm already like 12 episodes. So I got 40 more weeks. But I don't know if after my 52 weeks, I'm still gonna be doing vlogs.
Why?
It's just something I want to do. It's just like, maybe in a few years time, I can, you know, I can look back and say, oh, I've done vlogging before. It's just a goal. At least in years to come, I can look back and say, you know, hey, I've tried vlogging before. I've done vlogging for a year. I want to look back
and well,
show to my children and grandkids. Please. By the time YouTube no more already. Anyway, TikTok is also a good platform now. I see people are releasing music on TikTok. It's just that when
you gotta do a good one lah, don't do stupid ones lah.
Yeah lah, like professional kind of TikTok lah.
Yeah, professional, okay lah. You do stupid one or that for what?
The thing about social media platforms like Twitter or TikTok, whenever I browse to these platforms, I feel like either I'm too old or I feel like I'm a pedophile because everyone is just so young.
Yeah, that is why that's TikTok.
And then, you know, when I download TikTok, what do you think at first? Do you think that I was gonna look at young pretty girls?
No.
Right?
I didn't know what's in TikTok actually. I just know that they do silly dance.
Yeah.
Maybe one day when I have time, I will go through what is in TikTok. But so far, I never see.
There are stupid videos, a lot of stupid videos, but there are some good ones. We just have to learn the TikTok or Twitter works. Like for me, I really can't do Twitter. I don't understand Twitter. For me, Twitter is like too fast. All the news feed is like too fast. If you miss it, you miss it. And then there's retweet lah, there's repost lah, whatever lah. And then none of my friends are on Twitter, so I have to follow younger people. When I follow younger people, I feel like a pedophile.
At least around even like risky.
Even if it's risky generation, like I'm 33 this year. If I follow someone like 22, 20 year old, if I follow a guy is okay lah, but if I follow a girl, immediately she would think I'm a pervert. But you get what I mean or not? But even if I follow a guy, I could be like a gay pervert. People would think I'm a gay pervert.
I really don't know what's in TikTok, so I don't know. I don't have any.
TikTok is just like entertainment lah. Like we used to have Friendster. MySpace. But that was our way of social networking. I want to get to know it, you know, but I want to stay up to date.
Maybe you should do one TikTok.
Yeah, but I saw some music producers, you know, showing how they produce music. But yeah, recently I haven't been really producing music. I've been doing more of recordings, and when I record other people's music, I can't post it because it's like a spoiler, you know. It's not my song. I don't have the right to, you know. Can I post this? And I don't want to ask the artist whether I can post this or not, because I know the answer is always no. They don't want any spoilers lah. So I can only do it with my own music, which so far I have none lah. Only our original that's coming soon. Yeah, tomorrow we're going to the studio.
I've been very sick recently.
To finish it up. Yeah, you've been sick for like for the past 2-3 weeks. And you're doing the vocals. We recorded the vocals, but then I just feel like we need to tweak a little bit and like re-record some of the vocal parts before we finish it off. So yeah, I think I'm gonna keep this week's vlog very simple lah. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon so you don't miss any of the videos that I make. Leave your comments below. My name is Kash, this is my wife Ras.
Hi.
Be nice to everyone, and I'll see you next week. Cabut! Cabut.